We want to determine the equation for the graph in red based upon what we know about the graph of y equals the absolute value of x, which is graphed in black. So we'll let f of x be equal to the basic absolute value function. We'll let g of x be our transformed function. And then because g of x is a transformation of f of x, we can write g of x in the form given here below, where a, b, c, and d transform the graph of f of x. So the first step here is to describe the transformation that has occurred. And there are several things going on here. Obviously, the V shape is upside down, so it's been reflected across the x-axis, but the V is also not the same shape, which means the black graph has been either vertically compressed to form the red graph or horizontally stretched. Let's go ahead and assume that it's been vertically compressed. And as we already said, it's been reflected across the x-axis. The good news is the value of A controls both of these transformations. Also notice the v, or the low point on the basic absolute value function, is at the origin, but the high point of the reflected function is the point here at 1, negative 2, which means the graph has been shifted right 1 unit and down 2 units. So right 1 unit and down 2 units. Well, because it's right 1 unit, that'll help us determine the value of c. And because it's down 2 units, that'll help us determine the value of d. Which means we can write g of x in terms of f of x as a times f of the quantity x plus c plus d. So what we'll do here is determine the values of c and d from the transformations, and then use a point on the red graph to perform substitution and solve for a. Because the graph has been shifted right 1 unit, that means the value of c is going to be negative 1. Remember, if c is negative, the graph is shifted right c units, and if c is positive, the graph is shifted left c units. So c is the opposite sign that you might think. But if d is positive, the graph is shifted up, and if d is negative, the graph is shifted down. Because this graph is shifted down 2 units, d is negative 2. So this gives us the function g of x equals a times f of the quantity x minus 1 minus 2. Remember, f of x is equal to the absolute value of x, so we can write this as g of x equals a times the absolute value of x minus 1 minus 2. And now to determine the value of a, we'll select one point on the red graph and then solve for a. So for example, if we select this point here where the x-coordinate is negative 3 and the y-coordinate is negative 4, this means g of negative 3 must equal negative 4. So let's determine g of negative 3. We would have a times the absolute value of negative 3 minus 1, that's negative 4, minus 2, this must equal negative 4. Now we'll solve for a, this will be 4a minus 2 equals negative 4. We'll add 2 to both sides, that gives us 4a equals negative 2, divide both sides by 4, and we have a equals negative 1/2. Notice a is negative, that gives us a reflection, then the 1/2 gives us the vertical compression. So now we have g of x, we just have to substitute negative 1/2 for a. So we have g of x equals negative 1/2 times the absolute value of x minus 1 minus 2. And that'll do it for this example. I hope this was helpful.